Hello there, guys and girls, and everything that's in between, and welcome again to another episode of Sinbad the Merchant. Last time, we acquired a small bodyguard of Sarranid horsemen, 8 in total, not huge, and we have finally started spending some money on our army and thinking about the future of our trade kingdom. The first thing we're going to be doing here is waiting for Emir Mundhadir to leave. We're going to start the episode off with 43,000 dinars. We're making decent profits everywhere, basically, because we deposited some really nice stuff, but we should be able to get a good amount of money even still. Even on our bad weeks, we'll get around 1,000, 1,200. So, at best, we won't be losing money. I'm trying to capture the Rodak Lord to get my status up a little bit with Emir Lachim. There we go. Let's actually find the guy and let's accompany him. So it appears, though, unfortunately, that we're heading into Kurgan territory. Alright, so here we go. We're gonna get we're gonna get some missions now, finally. There he is. The army's supplies are dwindling. He needs 7 heads of cattle. Alright, well, we went from merchant trading to having to guide cattle around. First, though, I want to recruit some more units. 20 is decent enough to be able to do what we need to do. Oh, they're following me. Come on. There he is. There we go, so that's 2. We're going to keep accompanying the army. Wait, how many days did we have? We have 9 days to finish, and we've already delivered 2, so we need to deliver 5 more. Gilbert Tiger Claw, he never actually did anything like this. Maybe in a weird universe, Gilbert Tiger Claw would come into contact with Sinbad the Merchant. Who knows? Take a hostile action. Give me the cattle. 9 heads of cattle. 9 heads. Wow. That is wonderful. All right, let's go. Okay, so for some reason the quest actually got canceled. I don't know why that happened. It just did. We got a quest to visit Lady Sophia. So now we have all these cattle with us. What do I do with them? I guess I'm just gonna slaughter them. Ouch. Here we go. So it appears that there is a battle going on in Inzuduk Castle. That's why this was cancelled, and this is actually going to be our first battle. Oh, I'm only gonna have 1 guy available. Okay, Rolf it is. Ready troops. Alright, so we're gonna join the next assault. Here we are. The first siege battle for Sinbad the Merchant. He fights with the Sarranids against the Rodaks. I hope we don't die. This one ladder stuff in Warband is actually pretty saddening. If you guys keep up or watch any of my Bannerlord videos or the Bannerlord news updates, if you look at the comments, you'll notice that actually most people want a new kind of siege system. So they seem to be doing well for themselves, though. The archers have made it up here. We can get into the castle. From selling items and making profits to this, life of Sinbad is a rather... Oh my god, what happened? Did I just get knocked out? I got knocked out. I got knocked the fuck out with 1 hit. Oh, Sinbad. Sinbad, please. Go back to doing your merchant stuff, Sinbad. This is Rolf, isn't it? No, who is this guy? Who am I? I don't know. I have no clue what is happening. Alright, well, I'm gonna go try to take off, to take out those guys over there. This guy is about to die also, actually. Is this one of my companions? Is this Marnid? No, it's not Marnid. Yeah, sieges in this game are pretty bad, as you guys can tell, but, after Sinbad was, I can't even get up here. What is this? I have to go all the way around. Can I climb? Yeah, I can climb. Yeah, I'm gonna ninja those bastards. Prepare to die. No, it is Rolf. Rolf doesn't look like that. Oh, what? Who is this? Who is this guy? What is happening right now? Who are these people I am playing with? I do not know. Oh, I'm gonna need to fall down there. I don't know why they're all saying for the Reich. There we go. Being diverted to assassination missions, my lord. Who is firing at us? Does it really matter? Oh, look, they're spawning down there. Do you see them? Look, we're gonna go get deal with the outliers over here. Again, I have no idea who this person is. It could be one of my companions. Well, I very much doubt it. Maybe he is. It is Ferentis. Ferentis the Great. Yeah, look at that. Ferentis is a fighter. Look at that. Ferentis. You beast of a man. Alright, let's run back down to the aid of our comrades. I probably should have equipped Sinbad with better gear before going into the battle. Oh man, there's lots of Rodox troops over there, actually. There's a lot of troops. Yeah, Ferentis, getting into the groove of things. He's supposed to be the peaceful guy, though, isn't he? Doesn't feel very peaceful to me. He's a kick-ass badass. They are on that gate. We must reach the second gate, comrades. Look at his swag peasant armor. Oh, victory is ours! Yeah! Alright, so let's see. Sinbad was wounded, Rolf was wounded, Marnid was wounded, Ferentis was wounded. What? How did we lose a Sarranid horse? This is weird. Anyway. The remaining defenders have retreated to the castle as a last defense. You must go in and crush the remaining resistance. With who? Is it Sinbad? It's Sinbad again. Come on, Sinbad. Fight, Sinbad! A shield bashing pro. Sinbad. Yes! Sinbad wins. So it appears he wasn't really dead. He just ran into the castle to kill the guys in the middle or something. Alright, so I need to capture a lord still. Let's take a look at the party. Ferentis actually did level up. So, Mr. Ferentis, let's see your skills. So, he is the... He doesn't really have much of a specialty here. He does have Trainer, but Trainer is actually a leader skill in this mod, as I've said several times. I think I might give him looting, actually. Yeah, some more looting is nice. You can see his one-handed is starting to develop nicely. This was not the Ferentis we played with. I'm pretty sure we fought with a guy with another face. But alas! So the reason I am not picking kind of a diverse army at this stage is because I really just want to capture that Rodok Lord. So I want to kind of stick around and wait to see if... wait to see if I can catch one. So there's a Warchig tournament going on. Oh my god. The great Mongol hordes have left. Oh man. They're probably going to recapture that castle. There's a tournament here. We might join the tournament. But first we're going to go to the marketplace and we're going to get rid of all this beef. And yeah, why not? Let's join the tournament. So... what I am going to do is fight in the next round. Oh, I should have probably bet for myself first, shouldn't I? Control sprints in this mod. Kill him! Excellent.
I bring you despair.
He brings you despair. I guess Sinbad is a German.
I bring you despair.
You have started sprinting. Slam into the face. Come on, Sinbad. Get them kills. Get them kills, Sinbad. Look at Sinbad. He's so badass in tournaments, but when it comes to the real deal, the real dial, kill him. Get him. Get him. Sir Rahman, you are no match for the great Sinbad. This is basically how many kills I'm gonna get that round. I'm gonna keep it at 3. I probably should have increased it more at the beginning. I probably could handle a little bit more here in this one also, but 3 is just a safe option and I'll still make a good amount of money. Come. Come to me! Oh wow, that was a nice block indeed. Prepare to die! Oh. So that's 1 point. I need to acquire 2 more. Those are... there's a red guy there. A red archer. So that's 2 points. Now I need to get 1 more kill. And I'll get the payout. Captain Hatim has been knocked off his mount. Javelin, you say? Very well then. Oh, I missed him. Ooh, that was a good hit. I just hope he doesn't get killed by my friends. Teammates, don't kill him. No teammates. Yes, I got him. So that's 3 points. Now I get my wager. Or the money back. Whee! Fantastic. I got 6 points there. See? You'll see? And I also got the swiftest cut. No, swiftest cut was a Sir Salome Fisher's competitor. Also Sir Ramsay. Why? Why Sir Ramsay? He won some renown, as you can see. So as it goes on, it gets more and more difficult. And you can actually choose your... I don't know if I did this in a previous episode where you can actually choose the kind of the gear that you get. I've always chosen the two-handed stuff because... I find it to be very effective. No, Sinbad died. He got one hit KO'd by Rahim. All right, so I won the first place. I got 1,150 experience, 25 renown, 2,000 dinars, and I also got the Great Helmet. So the Sarranids... Oh. They're not at war with the Kurgats anymore, actually. So they just switched to the Rodoks. Now they're doing trade agreements with the Kurgs. This is really good for me. So let's actually stick around with the Kurgats and see where they're headed. They must be like, oh, it is Sinbad the Merchant, the maker of the best ale in the Calradia. He accompanies us, men. We're giving them morale boosts, you see, because we produce the best ale. We should have been carrying some ale with us just for roleplay purposes. They're headed deep, deep into Rodok territory. And we are getting some valuable scouting information here. Alright, so they are besieging Jelkala. Here. They are besieging Jelkala. I'm just gonna kinda chill around the area. And hopefully I'll get lucky. I'll find a lord. I'll fight him. So we know that Jelkala is under siege by the Kurgats. Lords of the Rodoks should be streaming in. Like, very, very much right about now, if they want to fight them back. So let's actually go back to the lands of the Sarranids. And when we do that, you'll be able to get more men. I'm going to now start balancing out the army. Because this guy's being chased. They're going to catch him. And now we join in. Perfect. We have lots more troops than they do. I'm going to tell all my guys to follow me. The objective here is going to be for us to capture that guy alive. I know that our chances are pretty slim. But you never know. Here are my glorious horsemen. Sarranid horsemen are a good troop, especially for these kind of battles. Our guys charge! Where's their lord? I need to find their lord. I simply don't see him. They're routing. The Rodoks are routing! I thought I would have to actually fight the Kurgats as the Sarranids, but it appears that we're helping each other here. Things are good. Look at that, that Kurgat Lancer. So buff. Must work out. Is that Marnid? That feels like Marnid to me. No, that's the glorious Ferentis. The great Ferentis. Oh, we leveled up. This is wonderful. Oh, what is this guy? Who's that guy? Arbalister. Okay. Well, I very much doubt that we took anyone I very much doubt that we took anyone prisoner. There's still more battles to be had. Let's continue the fighting. All right, follow me. Sinbad Dragoons. Hey. Do you see a lord among those? Nope, it's just another, what a shot. I actually got that. Even though his archery is atrocious. I got another one. Let's go. Now charge.
You will thank me later, Kurgit Lancer, for I have saved you.
Oh, that poor man. Oh man, my horse is in trouble. I need to be more cautious. What is happening now? Okay, everybody just get out of there. Get out of there. You're all blocking each other, you fools. Alright, are you out? Hehe, that's what she said. Now charge again. Nope, not yet. Wait. We won the battle yet again. My horse is in trouble. I need to get a better horse. So 43 left. We need to get a knockout on that lord. I don't know how the prisoner mechanics work. The fact that they were fighting the battle and we just assisted them. I don't know if we actually get access to the lord, but I'm probably gonna try it for a bit, and if it doesn't work, well, most likely won't work actually. I'll have to continue my plans of building up a bigger and more balanced army so that I can actually fight my own fights. Charge, friends. Yeah, cavalry on a battlefield like this. Look at Nisa. She's so ghetto. Oh no. Fall out. Put it out to. Oh, Nisa! No! Avenge Nisa, friends! Nice one. I should probably get the battle sizer and, oh no, what's happening? Oh crap! That's their spawn point. Be very careful. That's their spawn point. I hit a friendly troop. Sorry, bro. Go. Victory! Alright, excellent. Nisa is in trouble, though. She has been wounded. Alright, so... Chorkanduyan. I am Sinbad the Merchant. Oh, I got him! Can you believe it? I actually got him! Oh my gosh, 24 Sarranid Horsemen Assault Squad. We actually got a freaking count from the Rodox. I'm gonna marry Sophia. You are my prisoner. Alright, let's see here. Let's capture all these elites. We're gonna capture all these, and then we have room for one more. Let's capture the veteran one. Wow. I can't believe that happened.
Hello, my dear. I am sorry that our meetings are always so dreadful, but I am working on it.
That's fantastic. Zandina Mahayal, hello ladies, good day to you all. Munhir, Nuwam, Tidisman, Ganawa, Atis.
And there he is, the stashed. We meet again, Sinbad. Remember how the enemy squealed when we came over the walls of Undazak Castle? They had thought they were safe. We wiped the smug smiles off their face. Indeed.
About the task you gave me.
Oh, indeed. I have captured a lord from the kingdom of Rodax for you, Lachmir Lachim. Many thanks, my friend. He will serve very well for a bargain. You've done a fine work here. Please accept these 2,000 dinars for your help. So Lachim has now hit the cooperative. Look at this. We're doing so well. But see, what should I tell him? I should tell him it was nothing. Indeed. I'm going to be his brother-in-law in the future.
But we might actually play one more tournament since it is... There's another tournament happening, so why not, right? The more the money, the better. Here come the blue knights from behind us. We need to clear them. We did win last time, but we didn't actually get that much money. So it looks like our winnings from this episode are actually going to be mainly tournament-based, battle-based, and because we got that lord for Lachem. Things could not be going better for Mr. Sinbad here. But there is a predicament. All this cool stuff that's been happening to us is kind of good. The Sarranids are coming back to strength. They are becoming a little bit stronger. So I don't know. I don't know how it's going to be possible for Sinbad to kind of just split off and fight them again. We might have to think of another way. But for now, I am happy to see things go well for Mr. Sinbad. I'm just going to finish off this tournament. I probably won't bore you guys with the fighting. I'll maybe cut it here and show you kind of the results after, if I do well or not. And then I'll show you the money screen. Oh, wow. Watch it, man. Or even better, I'll probably just add an annotation where you can skip the combat. And just head to the end of the episode. So I'm just going to continue fighting here. That's a footman archer. That's a good target for me. Keep that target between us. Owie. Man. You know, I've been playing Warband, or I used to play Warband a lot online back when I was in Canada. I wasn't the best, but you know, I was pretty good. I played competitively for a while, I played in tournaments. I represented Canada in the World Cup of Warband. But now my game is just... I'm so rusty. I'm so bad at blocking. And I'm sure Sinbad's horrible stats for melee are probably a bit getting in the way, but still, I mean, I'm missing some easy blocks. Come here, knave! Yeah, see? Like, stuff like that shouldn't be happening. Oh my gosh, that's funny. That's Emir Lachim? Wait, Emir Lachim was a yellow guy. Did he die? Oh, I hate this camera thing. If I hit end, I can switch camera game modes. Camera game modes. It's follow cam now. Free cam. Alright, let's do follow. Maybe... This is rather boring, isn't it? Oh, there we go. Still am at the lead. I need to win this round, though, to make some good money. Because I think if you die, even if you get the points, it's not enough. You don't get the... You might win the tournament, but you don't get the money you bet for. Like, if I bet 150 for myself and I lose that round, I don't get the payout. It counts to my overall kills in the tournament, and it helps me win it, but yeah. I should try to avoid that to make as much money as I can. Oh, what a kill. Got him. There's an archer there. Let's ride this horse. Oh, that was a mistake. Oh, javelin. Got him. I don't see anyone. Oh. Come at me, bruv. There's one. Oof. That was rather close. Oh, Emir Dihul shot me down. See, again, I win, I get a siege crossbow, but I don't get lots of money because this... silly men. All right, to the feast. I wish Sophia was here because then I could give her the win. Nonetheless, I think I'm going to end this episode by just going over here to the party. I'm going to go talk to Marnid. And let me see his equipment. So, actually, before that, let's take a look at his skills. He does have 10 strength. Now he has 12 strength. And I want to give him... Let's see. Weapon Master is not quite necessary for him. Power Strike would be good. And I'm going to give him more in Crossbow. Because the Siege Crossbow we just won... Let's compare it to his Crossbow. His Crossbow does 44 damage... compared to the 66 damage of this one. But this guy can be used on horseback, so I'm actually going to keep it with him. This is a really, really expensive... Oh, look at this. I got a silver stag emblem. That's great. So I'll keep these. I'll probably sell them somewhere. Before we finish here, let's also talk to Jeremis. He needs an upgrade in skills. He also requires strength. So as you can see, we're just buffing up everybody at this point. Just buffing them up. I'll probably, once I start fighting more, I'll probably like actually go through every one of them and give them proper kits and everything. But for now, I'm just letting them do their thing. Here we are, guys. You can see that we have actually made a good amount of money considering that we have really been fighting throughout this episode. We kind of lucked out in that the first kind of field battle that we had with the Brodox, we managed to acquire the Brodox Lord for Lachem. So things are going well on that front. However, it's starting to look a little bit dangerous in terms of the faction, starting our own trade empire. You can see Suno is not really making any money if we don't do the exchange of manually putting in goods. It doesn't do too well, so we're going to have to kind of worry about that next episode. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the latest episode of Sinbad the Merchant. Please do like the video and comment down below if you have any suggestions or comments. And I'll see you all next time. Thanks for watching and take care.